Greetings YouTube, it is I, Garrett. Welcome to another Small Streamer Talks video, a series where we break down advice, tips, and tricks that we've heard from other streamers, big stream doctors, and just things in general, and we try to apply them in meaningful and helpful ways. So with that, let's get just right down to it with number one, collab with other creators. Now, that can mean a lot of things to a lot of different people. For me, one thing that I do is I like to just stream with other streamers. Partners on Twitch can do squad streaming, but if you are not a partner, then you can simply just stream with another streamer while they're streaming as well. Simple as that. Just include their Twitch link, their name, in any kind of notification message that you put out there when you go live. Say, hey, going live, playing this game with this streamer. Come check it out and hang out with us. And check out this other streamer. That's a really good way to help you grow your community as well as another's community. And same goes for them. They are growing their community while growing yours at the same time. And collab doesn't mean you just have to stream with other people. You can do things like an auto host list. So while you're offline, when one of the people that you follow goes online, your Twitch will automatically start to host them. So anytime somebody comes to your channel to check out what's going on, they'll be directed to their channel instead. That's something that I do for all of the other small streamers that I follow on Twitch. I have them on an auto host list. So anytime they go live, they get a host from me. If they're not already being hosted by somebody else, or if I'm not hosting somebody else already as well. And that wraps up number one. It's pretty quick, pretty simple. But it also kind of rolls into number two. Number two is a little bit more of a serious note. Don't expect a lot of your support to come from other streamers. They are working on growing their brand, their community. They don't necessarily have time to advertise for you, do a ton of raids, hosts, sending their community your way. They're working on building their community, and you are working on building yours. You can't expect them to be just holding each other's hands along the way. It's like asking somebody with a 40-hour-a-week job to help you with your 40-hour-a-week job. It's just not going to work for either of you. You're just going to stress each other out, and you're going to just get burned out, and you're going to quit altogether. So it's good to help other streamers. It's helped to collab, as I said in number one. But don't expect a lot of support from them. And in number three, don't feel like you have to have all the things. My all the things rule. It's also called my have to rule. I've seen a lot of times people that are new to streaming, whether it's Twitch, Facebook, YouTube, Mixer, whatever. Hey, I'm thinking about streaming, but I don't have a webcam. And you just see the responses come in. Well, you have to have a webcam. You have to have a nice PC. You have to have a capture card. You have to have a good headset. You have to have cool effects and overlays. You have to. You don't have to. So it's my all the things / the have to rule. You don't have to dump money into a stream that is brand new. Okay, it is not a baby. You don't have to pour a ton of money into it. That kind of thing will come later. What you need to focus on is hitting the go live button and just not be boring. That's as simple as it is. And not being boring can be interact with your chat. Respond to anything they say. If they do a redeem channel points reward, if you have that, go along with it. I have some channel point rewards on mine that are actually torturous to me. There's one that Twitch actually provided. It's called Reverse Reverse, where anytime somebody redeems it, I have to flip my controller upside down, or my keyboard flips it upside down, and my friends love to torture me with that, especially when I'm playing hard games and it's a crucial moment. So be interesting, be fun, be interactive. Don't just sit there in silence and wait for somebody to start a conversation. I kind of got off track there. That was more my you don't need all the things rule, and it just kind of rambled on into something else. So I apologize for that. But getting back to it, as long as you can go live and you can build a following, eventually you'll get there. I know it's hard to be patient. You know, you just started out, you've been streaming for months, maybe years, and you're not getting any revenue. I know it's hard, but that kind of goes back to my video from last week of be patient. It'll happen over time. You see, a lot of times, it's a grind. It is. It's a grind. And with that grind will come new toys, a new webcam, a new headset, keyboard, mouse, microphone. I don't even have an actual microphone yet. I'm still using my headset microphone. Right now, I'm using my headset microphone. So, if you can be a successful streamer without a microphone, without a nice webcam, and you can be successful and grow your way to it, you've probably got a pretty bright future ahead of you. But don't feel like you have to have it all in the very first few months of streaming. I know with the COVID-19 pandemic, webcams were bought up like crazy, so it took forever to even get one. So if you don't have one, don't feel like you have to have one. I follow plenty of very successful partnered streamers that don't have a webcam, period. They just don't want one. They don't have it. That means they didn't have to spend money on lights and other fancy effects for their faces. So you don't have to have all these things to get started. Good idea to add them later. Don't need them to get started. So with that, I want to know your opinions. I want to know any of your tips and tricks that you might have heard. So if you are another small streamer and you see this video, leave your name or comment below things that I can include next week on the next video. Let me know if you're out there. And as always, I stream on Twitch Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday in the evenings, Central Time. It's on my Twitch. I'll leave a link for that in the description along with my Twitter. That's usually where I will post the random strange thoughts of the day. And sometimes my stream schedule, I'll post there when I go live. And I'm just kind of weird on Twitter anyway, so you might think it's funny, you might not. But with that, I bid you happy streaming and farewell.